Hi, and welcome to today's session. Today we're going to be talking about how to more readily and easily complete your Using Sources worksheet. For this assignment, you're going to go into our university library. All resources need to come from the university library, and you're going to locate at least three credible sources that you can use to support the arguments that you're laying out in your essay. Okay, so how do we do this? The first thing you're going to want to do is go into our university library. Right, and when you do this, I always recommend not using the search keyword section here. I recommend going a little bit deeper into our library and choosing a specific database. There are two databases that I highly recommend. They're very generalized databases full of lots of academic articles and credible resources. So in order to access those databases, you'll click on University Library, and then you'll click on General Resources here. The two databases are called EBSCOhost and ProQuest, and both are excellent. Okay, so for today's example, I'm going to use EBSCOhost. All right, and as you can see, then I have another search bar readily available to me. So I'm just going to type in critical thinking and development in college. I know that one of the topics I'm writing about in my essay is critical thinking and the skills needed therein, so I'm just going to go with this real kind of vague topic, and we'll see if anything good pops up. Okay, critical thinking development in students during college. Okay, so this sounds like a totally appropriate topic and article for me to use. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this article. I can also see that it comes from an academic journal, which is awesome. Okay, so that means that it has been through an editing process and submitted. It's scholarly in nature, so this is going to be a credible resource for me to use. So I'm going to click on that resource, and as you can see, then all of the bibliographic information comes up. The abstract will hold a summary of the entire article. In order to access the article itself, I would go over here and I would hit PDF. Okay, and then that will generate the article that I want to read. You'll see some buttons over here as well, and these are awesome buttons. The most important button that I want to talk about right now is the Cite button. Okay, so as you can see, the little thing comes that says Cite. All right, so I'm going to click that because I know for my essay assignment today, I'm going to be doing a lot of citing. Okay, so what the Cite feature does for you is it automatically generates an APA formatted reference citation. Okay, you can see it also generates different types of reference citations, but the one you are interested in is the APA one, because we are using APA formatting for this assignment. So in order to be able to, I know I need to have that generated, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight it with my mouse, and then I'm going to hit Control C, and that copies it. Okay, then I'm going to go back to my worksheet, and I know that at the very bottom, I need to provide a formal APA reference citation. Okay, so I will then copy and paste that there. And as you can see, I have this lovely green background. I don't want that. Okay. But also notice that there's also a section that's been italicized. So I just want to take note of what has been italicized. Then I'm going to copy it again, highlight it all again. I'm going to go up here to this button called Erase Clear Formatting. Okay, it has the eraser by it. I'm going to clear the formatting for it. Okay, and then remember, so that nicely cleared my formatting. Now I do, however, need to go back and italicize what was italicized before. Okay, so now I've already got a nice worksheet completed, so that feels good. Now, I'm looking at the questions asked of me, and I see the first thing I have to complete is the title of the article. Okay, so I'll go back, and here's my article again. I'm going to get out of this citation format because I've already got that information. And the title of my article is Critical Thinking Development in Students During College Education Process. So again, I can highlight it, copy and paste it right into my worksheet. If it comes up with anything different, I can just fix that real quickly. critical thinking during the college education. All right, so that is the title of my article. All right, why did I choose this article? I'll fill that in. It's related to my topic, etc. Is the article credible? Okay, well, I believe so. So, I know it came from an academic source, so I can note that. Let's see. Oh, here we go. It's a little bit of information about all of the degrees that all of the authors hold. So I know that everyone who wrote this article is highly educated. I have professor of pedagogy, doctor of pedagogical sciences, so each one has their credentials noted. So this should be a good resource for me. These people are informed and educated on the topic on which they're reporting. Okay. So that is all information that I would want to include in that section of the worksheet about why the article is credible. And then, is the article biased? Well, you'll have to make that determination on your own after you read the article. Is the article relevant? It should be if you've chosen it. Then the next bit of required information is to find a passage you might use and summarize it. Okay. So a cited summary needs to be, when you summarize something, you need to summarize the entire article or the entire book or whatever. Okay, so in this case it's an article, so I would summarize the entire article. So, and then anytime I summarize information or paraphrase it or directly quote from it, I need to provide an in-text citation. For a cited summary, the in-text citation needs to include the author's last name and the year. So I need to go back down to here where I copied my reference citation, and I need to add in all of the author's last names. The initials are not needed, so I need to get rid of all of those. Okay, and I need to note the year. In this case, it came from 2016, a very recent source, which is awesome. Okay, all right, so now I have completed my cited summary, okay, because this was the summary I already wrote ahead of time to save time when I'm presenting this to you. Now, for the next section, you need to include a cited paraphrase. How do we do that? Paraphrases are short excerpts of information paraphrased into your own words, okay? They, too, need to be cited. So in this case, I would recommend writing down the original passage, okay? And then, as you can see, if you take the time to read these two, then for my cited paraphrase, I put everything that's noted here into new words. Everything is freshly phrased and reflects new phrasing. It still, however, reflects the ideas that these authors have published. So I need to give credit where credit is due because they're their ideas. So I have to also cite that information. And in-text citations for cited paraphrases include the author's last names, the year, and the page, and the year only. So the author's last names and the year are used for cited paraphrases. Finally, a direct quote is required. So what you need to do is look through the article until you find something that stands out to you and you love the way they phrased it. You think, you know what, if I tried to paraphrase that, it wouldn't sound as good. Or, you know what, that's a really powerful statement, I'm going to use that as a direct quote. Direct quotes that you choose should be around 30 to 40 words in length, no more than 40. And when you choose them, they really need to express things in unique and powerful ways, okay? So be selective when you choose your direct quote. In this case, I already selected my direct quote, and it is the phrase, "Critical thinking helps them to adapt to market economy and to develop business skills and professional competence," okay? So I like that phrase, and it will probably support the ideas that critical thinking skills are really important, and I'm talking a lot about that in my essay, so I like that. Now, also important, anytime you directly quote someone or multiple authors, you need to include that information in quotation marks. Critical, okay? So I need to, so when you are inserting your cited direct quote here, put the direct quote into quotation marks, and then you'll have your in-text citation again. But with in-text citations for direct quotes, they need to include the page or the paragraph number. Sometimes you have pagination where there is no pagination, like on an online site or something, and then you would need to note the paragraph. You would need to count down the number of paragraphs. But in this case, I know that the direct quote came from this page, and when I look at the page, it's page one. So I would just go right in here, and after 2016, I would hit page one. Okay, notice also that after my summaries, and after my paraphrases, and after my direct quotes, I don't have a period. Okay, the period goes after the in-text citation, just a little side note. So overall, I hope that I have helped you more readily complete this assignment, and if you have any questions at all, please just ask. Have an awesome day out there, and I will talk to you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.